The fate of Jenny in the human centipede first sequence. First of all, her knees are completely destroyed, so she can't physically get up. Her mouth is sewed onto Katsuro's rectum, and her rectum is sewed onto her best friend's Lindsay's mouth. So within the movie, she already ate human shit and shat into her friend's mouth. At the end, everyone around her is dead, and she's just stuck there. The fate of Andrew Logan King in Get Out. Imagine being trapped in your own body who is controlled by someone else. That's basically the sunken place. You observe the remainder of someone else's life through your own eyes. That's worse than death.
Get out.
Sorry, man.
Okay.
Get out!
Yo!
Yeah.
Yo, chill, man.
Get out!
Chill!
Get out!
Chill!
Chill, man!
We're gonna chill!
Get the fuck out of here!
The fate of Katie in I Spit in Your Grave 2. One of the most brutal tortures ever portrayed in a film. She got sexually assaulted 3 times in the movie. She got drugged, human trafficked and kidnapped, beaten to half death, peed on, tasered, and finally buried alive. She survives all of it and thankfully gets revenge on all of her abusers. The fate of Desuo in Oldboy. He gets kidnapped and spends 15 years alone in a room. He then gets released and falls in love with his own daughter Mido. He didn't know it was his daughter. Just for him to find out the truth at the end. He goes to a hypnotist so he can forget that she is his daughter, but it didn't work. The fate of the pregnant woman in the Human Centipede 2 full sequence. She got hit on the head and kidnapped by Martin. He believed she was dead, but she wasn't. She heard and saw the whole torture of the other people who got turned into a human centipede. In the last attempt, she runs to her car, gives birth in the car, steps on her newborn baby and kills it. And drives away. That's pretty brutal. The fate of Marty and Found. There's nothing worse than your parents getting killed. Well, except for you hearing their deaths and you waking up to their corpses with no eyes. The worst part is, your brother, who you loved, did it and is still on the loose.
But I keep myself under control. If I lose it now, I might not come back for a long, long time. Stuff like this can really warp a person.
The fate of Wallace in Tusk. One of the most disturbing movies ever made. Wallace gets literally turned into a walrus. The doctors probably couldn't even try to heal him because he's completely deformed. His tongue is gone, so he can't even speak anymore, he can only growl. And now he has to live with this for the rest of his life, seeing his girlfriend heartbroken, and has nothing he can do about it. The fate of Anna in Martyrs. She gets tortured in one of the most cruel and disturbing ways you will ever see. The cult who abuse her believe that there's only one way of finding out what happens after death. By torturing someone to the point of death. We're not talking about a near-death experience or when people are clinically dead for seconds or minutes. No, they think that by torturing someone so much that their body is already dead, but their mind is still on this planet. She gets beaten to unconsciousness just to get woken up again to get hit again. When they believe that Anna is on her last moments, that's when they do the final stage. They skin her alive. And yes, she's indeed still alive after this. The fate of David Drayton in The Mist. Incredible film, by the way. David has to kill his friends and his own son because they believe it is over for all of them. But he only has 4 bullets left, so he decides that he will live. Just for seconds after to realize that if he had waited a bit longer, they would have all survived. What an ending. The fate of Christine in Drag Me to Hell. I believe this is the worst horror movie fate of all time, because she gets literally dragged to hell. But she doesn't physically die, she's still alive. And you know what hell means, eternal suffering. And I personally don't think there's anything worse than being tortured to eternity.